Welcome back to Up North at 4. This is our last day of political conversations today, with the DNC wrapping up yesterday. We now welcome Northern Wisconsin's Congressman, Republican Tom Tiffany. Tom, how are you doing today?
Yeah, good afternoon, Dan. Good to be here.
Well, we heard Joe Biden last night make his case for the presidency. So I'm curious, why do you think Donald Trump is the better option for Americans, and specifically for these Northern Wisconsinites that you represent?
You know, I think when you look at the closing speech last night by Joe Biden, you heard a lot of platitudes. There was very little substance. And knowing Wisconsin voters the way I do, they want to hear some substance. And I think there's a lot of people that were disappointed that he didn't come and deliver that message, that Joe Biden didn't come to Wisconsin. I mean, it's much like Hillary Clinton 4 years ago when she did not come to Wisconsin. Wisconsinites want to be able to hear. They want to hear what your message is. They want to be able to really test who you are as a candidate so they can make a good, informed decision, because Wisconsin voters are, I mean, they're savvy. They know how to go about making a judgment of political candidates. And I think Joe Biden fell a little bit short there. But when you look at North Central Wisconsin and President Trump, I mean, there's been a lot of good things happen up here. This is a heavily agriculture and manufacturing region up here. And President Trump, with the USMCA agreement, which replaced NAFTA, if you remember, NAFTA was passed back in the 1990s. Joe Biden supported it. It was a bad deal for people here in Wisconsin and across America. And President Trump has ended these bad trade deals that were put in place over the last few decades and put ones in that put America first. And I think that's part of the reason why you're going to see people here in northern central Wisconsin, throughout Wisconsin, are going to support President Trump here in November.
Yeah, Congressman, the election is now 73 days away. 4 weeks ago, the president said he would unveil the Republican health care plan in 2 weeks. It's now been four. Where is the plan? Where is the plan hiding? And are you behind the plan?
So I have not seen a plan come forth. All I know is that the specific plan that you're talking about, but what I've seen with this president is he has talked about and implemented plans to control pharmaceutical costs, something that is near and dear to people across this district, especially the elderly. And he has put in a plan to get control of pharmaceutical costs, and also he has put in a plan to have greater transparency, because that's really the secret to affordable health care, is to have more transparency so the people out here know how much they're paying, whether it's for their pharmaceuticals or for their health care expenses when they go into the doctor.
Congressman Tiffany, the first bill that you recommended in Congress would withhold funding to schools that did not go into in-person classes at a certain date in early September. Why was this your first bill? Why do you feel so strongly that students should be back in classes?
You know, as a father of three children, including one that's still in high school, we cannot lose a generation of kids. And that's what's happening. I've been talking to parents across this district, as well as administrators and other school officials, teachers, and they're deeply concerned about kids not getting back into the classroom, because we already lost a significant amount of the last school year. You have some diminishment that goes on every summer. We got to get kids back in the classroom. And I wanted to make sure that we're incentivizing schools to get kids back in the classroom. And we can do it safely and responsibly.
So you kind of made the pitch there on why. When I think of conservatism, I think of local control. This is something that you often preach. Why did you feel that this was the opportunity for federal oversight when so often you recommend local oversight?
Yeah, I would say in regards to local control, I don't preach that. I share that message with people that it's best to have that local control. And that's what we're seeing happen here in Wisconsin. I hope Governor Evers stays with that message, that we're going to allow local school districts to make that choice. I think that's a really good thing. But I think it's also important to incentivize schools to get kids back in the classroom if possible, because we're going to lose a generation of kids if we don't do that. I mean, just look at the information that came out from both the Centers for Disease Control. Dr. Redfield said, get kids back in the classroom. And the American Academy of Pediatrics, they came out with a strong message saying that it is really important we get kids back in school. Otherwise, we're going to lose them to drugs and alcohol. Child abuse is up. We're seeing suicides. And That's what happens when you don't have kids, when they can be in a socialized setting where they can be with their friends and stuff like that. School is a very important component of their lives. Taking that away from them and taking that away from them in person can really have harmful effects.
Congressman, Vice President Pence was in Darien on Wednesday. Very friendly territory, hasn't voted Democratic in 100 years. Is this a sign the campaign is now shifting toward away from persuasion and now on to just getting out the vote?
Oh, no. We're continuing to persuade voters. And I'll tell you, one of the most powerful messages that's out there right now is safety and security. We have a party. If you listen to Joe Biden last night, he has still not said that we should defend the police. He's still not criticized those in his party who are saying we must defund the police. Look at Minneapolis, where you have the city council that has said we're going to defund the police in spite of the riots and looting that have gone on over there. And Joe Biden still has not criticized that. We're going to get a lot of voters that are concerned about safety and security. And I can see it in talking to people across the district. The energy is really helpable out there for Republicans on this safety and security issue.
Last question here, Representative Tiffany. I'm going to play devil's advocate one more time. Sure. On your school's proposition. Some kids, they may have parents who are immunocompromised, and even teachers, they may be a caretaker with grandparents who are immunocompromised. How do you reconcile those problems with sending students back to school?
That's why you should have local control of schools, so that schools can make that decision. I mean, if you look at school districts across the North, what I'm seeing them say, you can have a virtual alternative if that works for your family. Schools are being flexible in that way. And the bill that we put forth at the federal level, it allows schools to be able to opt out if they need to do that. If there's circumstances that are unusual to them, they can opt out without jeopardizing their funding.
That's all the time we have today, Representative Tiffany. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Yeah, good to be here, Dan.
All right, thank you again. Right after the break, we're going to talk to Representative Tiffany's opponent this November, Tricia Zucker. Stay with us.